नमस्कार, मेरा नाम आशुतोष भोगना है और मैं सर्टिन में एज ए साइंटिस्ट डी कार्यरत हूँ। आज हम साइबर सिक्योरिटी एश्योरेंस विषय पर चर्चा करेंगे। सो आवर लर्निंग ऑब्जेक्टिव इज टू अंडरस्टैंड साइबर सिक्योरिटी एश्योरेंस। देन वी विल डिस्कस द साइबर सिक्योरिटी एश्योरेंस फ्रेमवर्क इन इंडिया। वी विल डिस्कस साइबर सिक्योरिटी मैच्योरिटी मॉडल्स। वी विल सी हाउ द सेल्फ असेसमेंट एंड ऑडिट्स कैन हेल्प अस टू get the cyber security assurance, and then we will discuss the cyber security exercises. So what is the basically the cyber security assurance? So assurance, as we know, is a fact-based confidence. That's the we understand what the confidence is, but the assurance is the different from the confidence. It's the fact-based. You have some fact, based on that you are assured that. In a such a way, in terms in cyber security, assessment of effectiveness of controls, are they working as we believe? Our firewall is working as it is configured. So that's the cyber security assurance. Getting an assurance on the controls you implemented, whether it's working effectively or not. So cyber security assurance is a measure of confidence that the security features and architecture of systems accurately enforce the desired security. It's working what it is intended to do. When we see from the cyber security point of view, the assurance can be at a three levels. The organizational level. Organizational level means the controls implemented by an organization to do the cyber security. So they have to see how well their technical controls and policies are working, whether they are effective or not, to protect against the cyber threats. That's the organization level. Sectoral level, sector is specific. Like we have a different sectors. We have a oil and gas, we have a power sectors, we have a defense sectors, we have a transport sectors. So at that sector, whether that sector, the controls implemented by that sectors, policy initiated by that sectors are effective or not in assuring the cyber security of that specific sector. That's the sectoral level assurance. Then there is a national level. At a country level, we want to see how our country is, how our critical information infrastructure are, whether they are protected from cyber threats or not. So that's the national level cyber security assurance, and that's the basically to ensure that our critical infrastructure is protected from the cyber threats and the malicious actors. So that's the assurance. So how we will, what are the methods there to generate that assurance? How we will verify that the controls implemented are correct? So if you will see in a cyber security assurance framework in India, then you may refer to the National Cyber Security Policy 2013. That's available on the Ministry of Electronics and IT websites. And that policy talks about compliance and assessments. That policy talks about the cyber security assurance frameworks. And it states that the focus is on the creation, establishment, and operation of cybersecurity assurance framework aimed at enabling government critical infrastructure organization and key IT users of a nation's economy. The main objectives are to protect the critical information infrastructure and the cybersecurity assurance framework. So in a cybersecurity assurance framework, basically two types of steps are there. That's the enabling and endorsing. So in enabling, what we are expecting is that based on the advisory, based on the regulation in a cybersecurity, based on the promotions. So those are the enabling actions for implementing the cybersecurity in a country as per the national cybersecurity policy. Then there are endorsing actions such as providing the trainings, such as the conducting the audits, such as the empanelment of information security auditing organizations by CERTIN, the certification program in a cybersecurity. Those are the endorsing actions. So those things are at a national level to ensure the cybersecurity assurance of a country. Then what are the tools available with us to generate the cybersecurity assurance? So there are cybersecurity maturity models. So what the basically the maturity models are? Maturity models are the benchmark against which you can assess and find out where you stand today and where you have to move to further improve your posture. So that's the basically the concept of the maturity models, and it's having the labels, that's we can say also the ladders which the organization can move step by step. So the basically the maturity models help organization to define its current posture, what is your current cybersecurity posture, determines its future and more mature state, how you can reach to the next state. That's the you can do from the maturity model. Identify the capabilities and skill set it must attain to reach that future state. So what the organization need to do to go to that next step, that's the can be defined by the maturity models. So this is the one of the maturity model known as a cybersecurity capability maturity model, C2M2. So in C2M2, it's to provide a flexible guidance to help organization to develop and improve their cybersecurity capabilities. So there are 10 domains basically with 4 maturity indicators. So what are the maturity indicators? It's defined as a maturity indicator 0, maturity indicator level 1, maturity indicator level 2, and then 3. So maturity indicator level 0 is there is no practices in that domain. 1 is there are initial practices in that domain. Then there are practices at regular and performed to in a systematic manner. So there are practices, those are regular, it's not an ad hoc basis. Then there are a maturity level 3rd, that's practices are it's matured enough, it's managed by the high level management. There are a top level policies for managing the cyber security of that particular domain in the 10 domains that are listed in C2M2. So this is the list of those 10 domains. You can go through them, like a risk management, like workforce management, cybersecurity program management, supply chain management. So those things, those domains are there, and then organization can do their assessment where they stand in those 10 domains, maturity level 0 to maturity level 3. And then what they need to do to improve to move to the next maturity level. So that's the how the maturity models can be used, and C2M2 can be used for the improving the cybersecurity posture of the organization to assess and improve the cybersecurity. So here is a link, you can get more detail from about the C2M2. So you can go to the link and read more about this maturity model. Then there is a maturity model known as a cybersecurity capability maturity model, that is CMM. It's for the nations, it's for the countries, developed by the Global Cybersecurity Capacity Center, and it's provide directions and assessment model for the governments, for the nations in 5 domains. So there are a cybersecurity policy and strategy as a first domain. Then there is a cyber culture and society. Then there is a cybersecurity education, training and skills. Then there are legal and regulatory frameworks. Then the 5th one is the standards, organization and technology. So this model CMM helped the nations to find out what they are doing, what their current posture against these 5 dimensions, and what they need to do to improve them further. So that's the that can help in the more mature state of a country. So maturity levels in defining this model are the startup, formative, then the established, strategic and dynamic. So startup means they are starting up, and then to the more mature model. So in each of the 5 dimensions that can be assessed, and then the nation can decide what they need to do to move to the next level. So these are help as the benchmark for the country to develop their improve their cybersecurity postures. So details of this model is also available at the link given at a slide. So you can visit the Cybersecurity Capacity Center and can have a look on the CMM model for the nations. Then there is another method for doing the generating the assurance, there's the self-assessments and audits. Self-assessment is basically the assessment done by the organization against any maturity model or a framework. So frameworks such as any cybersecurity framework or any other regulatory framework or ISO 27001, those type of standards can also be used for the internal audits and the assessments. So self-assessment is the self-assessment by the organization of their posture, how good they are in the cybersecurity and what they need to do to further improve. So audits, you know, in the case of audits, audits are the basically the internal or external audit. So internal audits are done by the organization and external by the third party auditors to verify and to see against the standard some audit criteria that organization is, what their posture is. So if you see the formal definition of your audits, it's the systematic. It should not be the ad hoc. It should be the systematic. It should be the independent. Means the auditor should not be have any relationship with the auditee, and it should be a documented process. You should document the audit process and audit findings for obtaining the audit evidences. Audit evidences you have to collect during the audits and evaluate them against extent to the audit criteria are fulfilled. So we have to find out to which extent the audit criteria, whatever our audit criteria is, whether it's fulfilled or not. So that we have to see from the, we can see from the audits that can help us to generate the assurance. So types of audit is the first party audit, second party and the third party. So first party means you are conducting the internal audits. So in case of an internal audit, organization are conducting their own audit. Second party audit, when they are, the organization client is conducting audit on them. So the client wants some services, but before giving them any contract and assignment, they want to conduct their audit. Then the third party is the third party auditor. They provide the certificate that the audit is performed by some third independent party. So that's the third independent party. It's not a client, it's not an internal audit, it's a third independent party for conducting the audit. So what can be the audit criteria be? It can be the ISO 27001, you may be aware about it. It's the information security management system. There could be the vulnerability assessment and penetration testing against the vulnerability assessment frameworks and penetration testing framework. That could be against NIST cybersecurity framework. That could be against the maturity model. So those are basically our audit criteria. What is generally performed in audit activities are these steps: initiating the audit, then preparing the audit activities, conducting, then preparing and distributing the audit report, completing the audit, conducting the audit follow-up, whether the findings are corrected or not. So that's the audit follow-up. So these are the basic steps taken by the auditor for conducting the audit. Okay, so cyber security exercises are another the method which we can use for the generating the assurance to find out how organizations are doing, how sectors are doing, how countries are performing. The cyber security exercises are of a different type: the functional exercises, operational exercises, simulated exercises, discussion based tabletop exercises. You can go through this classification in the slide to see different type of cyber security exercises. So basically, when it comes for exercise type selection, which type of exercise we should select, so it may depend upon the maturity of our organizations and the extent they want to do the assessment. So extent to the they want to do, so they can do the walkthrough, they can do the desktop exercises, they can do the hypothetical scenario based exercise, or they can go to for the full simulated exercises. What is suggested in this slide is that based on the maturity, cybersecurity maturity of the organization only, they should select, go for the full simulated exercise, and they should start from the basic exercises such as a desktop walkthrough or a tabletop exercises or the quizzes. So that basic type of exercise they should start, and then slowly they should move for a full simulated cybersecurity exercises. So this slide give you the example of a simulated attack based exercise. In that, there is a red team which is launching the attack on a setup of a participant. The participant may have typically intrusion detection system, monitoring system, communication devices, and then some setup to protect from against the attack. And on the exercise day, the red team will launch the attack on the that exercise setup. And then what the participant has to do, they have to respond as per their incident response plan. They have to investigate the incident, they have to respond to the incident, and then that exercise will bring out any gaps, if there is any in their plan, if there is any gap in their standard operating procedure, any gap in their policies, what they need to improve, that will come out from the simulated exercise. So this is one type of a exercise that we discuss. So based on the targets, the cyber security exercises are classified as organizational exercises. The exercise is conducted within an organization, maybe for the cyber security assurance awareness, maybe for the improving the coordination between different groups. Then there is a sectoral exercises in which a particular sector is on a target, like a finance sector. So all banks may participate in that exercise, and scenario and attacks will be based on the that particular sector. Then there are national exercises. National exercises are conducted in India also. That's the conducted at a country level. Then there are regional and international exercises where multiple nations participate to improve their coordination and collaboration in case of a cyber incidents and a cyber crisis. So this is the summary of this session. We discuss about the assurance, the importance of assurance in cyber security controls. What are the methods to generate that assurance? We discuss the tools, the different maturity models, the cyber security assurance exercises, audits, maturity models, and the self-assessment. So those things can be used for the generating the cyber security assurance at different level, that like we discussed at the organization level, sector level, and the national level. So that's all for this session. Thank you.